Well, here's an update to a story we spent a lot of time talking about. The U.S. news media, as you remember, immediately seized the chance to brand a group of high school boys from a Catholic school in Kentucky, Covington, as villains, bigots who were targeting people on the basis of skin color. Well, it soon emerged that not only wasn't true, it was the opposite of what happened, but it didn't matter. Journalists continued to use their power to browbeat and bully the high school kids. Here's one among many examples.
Do you feel from this experience that you owe anybody an apology? Do you see your own fault? We looked at that video and thought about how it felt from the other's perspective. In other words, there were a lot of you, a handful of the others. There's something aggressive about standing there, standing your ground.
Something aggressive about standing there. And journalists weren't the only ones to make that point. The Covington students' own Catholic bishop condemned them as well. Now, that bishop has apologized for what he said. He's admitted that he was bullied into denouncing the boys and that he never even looked at the evidence about what they did. Larry Elder's radio show host from Los Angeles. We're always happy to have him on the show. He joins us tonight. So, Larry, you've got to think, not just in the case of these boys, but in the case of anyone who's been called names by the media collectively and then found to be not guilty of the charges, how does that person get his reputation back?
Well, of course, the person doesn't get the reputation back. The accusation is made above the fold, page one. The retraction is made deeper into the newspaper. Yeah. What happened here is what I call the intersection of Trump derangement syndrome and what Tom Wolfe, the author who wrote the book Bonfire of the Vanities, calls the media's incessant search for the great white defendant. Nothing better for the media than a white man who's perceived as privileged that they can malign. And that's what happened with Mr. Nick Sandmann. And later on, it also happened to a friend of mine named Doug Adler, who used to be an ESPN commentator. 2 years ago, did a match involving Serena Venus Williams, used the term guerrilla tactics, not G-O-R-I-L-L-A, but guerrilla as in guerrilla tactics. And yeah. A New York Times tennis writer named Ben Rothenberg puts out a post and accuses Doug Adler of racism. ESPN demands that he apologize. Adler happens to be white. And he does to keep his job. They still fired him. And for 2 years, he's been battling a defamation lawsuit. Finally, he won it, got his job back. But the tennis sports writer at New York Times has not lost his job, nor has he apologized. Anybody in the tennis commentating field come to Doug Adler's rescue. Not the McEnroe brothers, not Martina Navratilova. None of these announcers said guerrilla tactic is a normal term used to describe a tactic in a match. And he got fired, got maligned as a racist, just like Nick Sandmann got maligned as a racist before the facts came in. The intersection of Trump derangement syndrome and the incessant search for the great white defendant.
Well, that's a shocking story. Gorilla spelled G-U-E, the French word. Nothing right. to do with the primate at all. It's a completely different word.
Nothing.
And he gets fired.
And Tucker, when ESPN approached him, he said what you said. He said, I didn't say gorilla as an animal. I said gorilla as in tactic. And they still fired him after he apologized. My goodness. Talk about hysteria. This is mass hysteria. It fit the script. This young man in D.C. was wearing the mega cap. He committed also the sin of being born white. He was privileged. And so the media just ran with that, just as they ran with a story about Doug Adler. It's outrageous.
And nobody stood up to defend him. They were all
nobody
cowards.
Did.
They just looked at their shoes.
One tennis commentator did, named Rami Koenig. He is a South African commentator.
Good
outside of that, nobody did. And Venus Williams could have stopped this in 5 seconds. I know she's busy, but my goodness, she could have stopped it in 5 seconds had she wanted to. Instead, she wouldn't comment. She just let him twist in the wind.
And wreck the man's life and reputation.
Right. And by the way, Tucker, he had a heart attack. His cardiologist said his heart was fine before the stress of being called an international racist for 2 years. And now he's gotten his job back with a settlement, but no apology.
You know, there really aren't many brave people left, which is part of the problem. You are definitely one of them. Larry Elder.
Well, thank
again,
you
it's always a blessing to have you on the show. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.